How is it going, my fellas? Welcome to the St. Paddy's Day event. St. Patrick's Day in Brawlhalla is not a huge event. We do get a new skin each year, but usually we get two. So this event is much lower on the cosmetic side, but we still have some pretty cool skins. Ones that I'm not huge fans of, but they're still good regardless. We got Kern Koji, this Sentinel skin. Don't ask me how to pronounce it. We have Mero Sidra, Warborn Olgrim, Ragnar the Covetous, and then with the three we're going to be playing today, we have Dragon Hunter Isaiah, Galaglass Jala, and Dolahan Jiro. I'm not going to be buying any new skins. I'll be playing just the three that I already own. So it'll be a shorter video today. I'm just going to play each of them twice. But as for the other cosmetics, we have the KO effect, which I will not be getting as usual. There is the Pot of Gold emote, which honestly, I feel like I'm legally obliged to buy every single event emote at this point just for the goofs. We also have the Goldmine avatar. I do like this avatar a lot, but probably won't get it. And then we have two new colors. We have it for Tezuka, which looks very nice. And then we also got Ezio. I do be liking them. The St. Paddy's Day color is pretty underrated, in my opinion. Besides that, we don't have anything else new. But we do have a new patch entirely. We got some new balance stuff. We got like a whole lot of quality of life changes. It was a pretty good patch overall. Although I think Gauntlet's got pretty much gutted. We will start by playing Jiro. I'll go Jiro, Jala, Isaiah, and then I'll play each of them one more time afterwards. I already went over the balance pass in another video, which if you want to look at my opinions on that, then you can end up going to the video. I released it maybe 2 weeks ago or so. I'm not entirely sure. Although a lot of the changes are kind of what I was expecting. There are some really insane ones that I want to get to on Isaiah. But as for another legend, let's say maybe Cross, for example. Cross got like absolutely gutted, but Gauntlet's Dare is absolutely terrible now. It's really funny if you ask me. Although I don't know how Gauntlet maids aren't how the Gauntlet mains are holding up right now. The answer would be probably not great. To be honest, I'm not a huge fan of Jiro either. I mean, he has Scythe. I'm not a big fan of Scythe, and he's got Sword, and I'm just a lesser fan of Sword. I feel like Jiro's really overrated, but also really underrated in the fact that a lot of people think he's really underpowered. I think he's pretty strong. He has really nice stats, so I don't know, a lot of people call his stats really bad, but I think his stats are pretty solid. Along with just some of his SIGs being absolutely nutty. Oh, wait. Whoops. I thought I was gonna make it back. I should have jumped first. I was just falling into the abyss. So if I can get early kill here and stop getting Nair. There we go. Spear Nair is hell. But we gotta deal with Katara's now. Fine by me. Actually, is it fine by me? I can't even tell. Sometimes I'm like completely fine with fighting Katara's, and sometimes it's like absolute hell. I'm like so close to dying. I didn't even land down there. Come on, man. Once we get to Jala and Isaiah, the games will be going much more smoothly. At least so I believe. I don't remember which true combo Jiro exactly has on Sword, but I know he's got one of them, and I failed it miserably. Thank God. Oh yes, she's dead. All right, we'll stick on Sword. Just because I feel like my Sword game right now is better. I don't remember how much people are doing wake-ups. Oh no. No. Hang on, I can make it back still now, hang on. No? Okay. That's what I get for standing right in the middle of Nye's down sig. I didn't expect it to go super great on Jiro. But we'll go to a legend I'm much better at, just because Jala has Axe alone, but it's also another Sword legend, which I'm not too keen of. But hey, it's a very classy Jala skin. I actually like this skin quite a lot. It's probably one of my favorites to run on Jala. I mean, what can I say? I think Jala fits, like, this Jala skin overall just, like, fits the St. Paddy's theme very well. They do a good job with the St. Paddy's skins. Like, they go really out of the box for them, and I think it's really cool. Alright. Whoops, alright. Alright, let's go, Orion. We've had our emoting time, huh? I was playing a ton of Jala earlier today. I think it was earlier today. It was like early this morning. And it was going pretty good. She has really good SIGs. Especially, well, okay, I need to stop falling into everything. It's especially like, what SIG is it? It's a downlight into in-SIG, I'm pretty sure, on Sword. Pretty good combo. Actually, love to get the KO here, but knowing us, we probably won't. Alright, there we go. Actually got a ride in there, so we're chilling. He might, he might be doing a lot of wake-ups, I don't know. Damn it. Listen, if anything, it's an Orion player. He's gonna be doing, down sig and in sig quite a lot. Oh, and also, Sayre. We cannot forget about Sayre. I've been noticing a lot of spear players are just Sayring a lot lately in general, and it's actually kind of irritating, huh? But, you know, it's not like a spear's OP. I just need to figure out how to counter it. No, oh my god. Damn, they, like, did that attack and dodged so quickly afterwards. Yeah, right, I forgot the gadgets got new, sound effects, too. I actually think that's pretty neat. It's very nice quality of life feature. Like I said, this entire patch is, like, quality of life features, huh? Alright, I'm getting unarmed to death right now. I hate fighting unarmed so much. I'd rather fight Lance, huh? And that's really saying something. Very close to losing, because Lance has some of the easiest kill confirms ever. I'm not being sent into that, thank you, huh? Thank God the bomb isn't there anymore. It's a very close game. Honestly, the Orion's just trolling me at this point. There we go. I think that's nearly knocking him. Oh my god. I didn't expect to beat him there, but that's what he gets for trolling around. Alright. Now going on to Legend, I'm actually decent at. We're playing Isaiah and actually at Blackburn, so I'll be running that. It's not my preferred to run Isaiah skin, but hey, I mean, that's pretty cool. Now, the thing I was talking about earlier, right? My man's has downlight side sig now. I don't know why they... Well, I guess I know why they gave Isaiah downlight side sig on blasters. It's just because Isaiah is like a heavily underutilized legend. You don't ever see Isaiah all that much. Okay, he's gone. Okay, but as I was saying with Isaiah, I understand why they give him downlight side sig. It's only at low damages, so it doesn't matter too much, but I suppose it's because Isaiah is just a really underutilized legend, and they want to make him more utilized. They want to give him more potential to be something really great. And I think with... Well, he already has so many sig true combos. I don't know what another one's going to do, but that one's very strong. Isaiah's sig kit in general is like already really strong. This, you like have to use it in the right way. Oh, I should have been doing the blaster combo. Alright, he's dead. No! Why can't I be goofy? I actually want to kill him now. Thank you. Go take it. Man's is on the lance now. Yep. I was gonna say, let's see if I can hit that thick. I suppose we won't do it right now. I do want to hit downlight sides like a few times. Maybe I'll be able to get it once. Now I'm just like kind of trying to focus on winning against Lance. No idea how much I hate this weapon. It's like the new blasters for me. Not even the new blasters. Lance and blasters for me are on the same plane of annoying. There we go. People just don't expect it. Here, we'll keep blasters. I need to hit that combo. Unless he runs away the whole game. There we go. Nope. Oh my god. He's such a Lance one trick, it hurts. Ooh, the read. Okay. Had to do the silly little taunt. That is what happens. I do not condone with Lance One Tricks. It is where I pass. And now we're going back to Jiro. Alright, sword 1v1, not my most preferred option, but we'll see how we can do. Again, I don't play the hottest Jiro. Jiro's very iffy for me. It's not a very fun legend, if you ask me. Sometimes I go ham on Scythe, but it really depends on what Scythe legend I'm playing in the first place, and Jiro's really not one of them. Okay. These offstage games are going too far. Like, he does a recovery, and he's gonna immediately do some shenanigans. Also, I like how I hit myself with the bomb. There's just no mention of that. There. That's what he gets for playing offstage too much. Way too much. Listen, I'm not even trying to force him offstage. He's just going offstage himself. Huh. Not gonna lie, I was expecting a hammer side dig. A lot of board of our players seem to go for that. What's he sticking on hammer, though? No. Almost had it. And remember ever I used to think that Jiro Sig was like the worst in the game? Doesn't really stand true anymore, does it? Oh, what am I doing down Sig? Might be able to get a kill here. There we go. One of the most broken Sig true combos. So we're dealing with sword here, I see. Oh, we have a nice lead. We just need to knock comboed into oblivion. I'll just do some down tick spam. Whoa, so it's a close game. Just need to hit a recovery or something. The roof on this stage is like ultra small, so. But I'm throwing the game. I hate playing Jiro so much. He is not fun. He's really not a fun legend at all. I don't really get it. I'll enjoy my times on Jala and Isaiah. Thank you very much. To be honest, that match is just not me. I completely threw at the end. I was trying not to get hammer shmammered, and I got hammer shmammered anyways. Alright, let's see what Nash has for us. Another hammer. Should I be scared? Probably not. I really don't hate fighting hammer at all. Hammer's fine to me. Although we're just kind of obliterating this guy right now. Not the right move. Listen, all I could ask for is like an early kill here. That's the only thing I could ask for. I just need to not whiff loads of my attacks. So. There we go. Killing with ground pound on the roof. Seems like a typical Brawlhalla game to me. We're just like gatekeeping him from a weapon for so long. Although if he keeps up some of these unarmed games, then maybe I'll think otherwise. Gotta get the wacky insigs. It's been a minute and we're already like two stocks down. This match is ending very quickly. Oh no. Alright, I'm back. Everything's cool. Love that call his game. Love the Mojala Sigs. Some of them really do go insane. So we'll be going on to the last game now. We're going to Isaiah. Hopefully we'll win this one too. If so, it'll just be all losses on Jiro and then all wins on Jala and Isaiah. Which I would gladly take. Although, we're having a double cannon off right now, so that'll be fun. I'll probably end up taking on blasters anyways, just because I gotta hit the combo. There we go. Got the good old combo on him. That combo alone is just like so fun to use. I love using it. It's making me just enjoy Isaiah so much more. But to be honest, Isaiah's always been a legend I enjoyed like a ton. I think just like, well, over like all of my years on Brawlhalla, he's always been one of my highest. I'm not getting off stage right now. We'll hit him with the side sig. And the insig. No, not the insig. Man, good thing they nerfed Onyx insig. Not like, I don't even think that would have changed anything. To be fair though, that sig was pretty powerful. Getting neutralized all over the place, though. No. I can live! Alright, not if I get bonked. We need cannon. Perfect. Damn it. If I hit that ground pound in the right way, he... Oh. Oh. I thought I was gonna be dead. I don't know why I'm trying to do combos that aren't true. Bam. Me just trying to be goofy 24/7. Game is actually ultra even right now. I still hit him with the insigs. Let's get a downlight insig. Let me just show off all of Isaiah's true combos. There we go. Ah, what were some of his other ones? I do know what one of them are. I'm gonna try hitting it. Here. Whoops, Although he has to be at like zero damage, so I don't think this is gonna work now. No, damn it. Yeah, it didn't work. Happens whenever I hit him like a single bit, so I couldn't get the combo through. Bouncing Sayre, it's so incredibly specific that like you wouldn't hit it in a million years. I don't think anyone has. In fact, time for another one of the true combos where I do GC Downsig Sayre or something along those lines. We have a nice lead right now. Oh wait, no, downlay insig, of course. There we go. We hit three of Isaiah's true combos in that game. Which we'll take it. With that being said though, again, I know the video is short, but that'll be for the St. Paddy's Day event. I'd say a short video for St. Paddy's actually kind of fits because St. Paddy's is a short event. There's not a lot of cosmetics to it, there's not a lot of things to it in general, but it is a good event overall, but I still think it's one of the lower events in Brawlhalla, but still a good event. I enjoy it whenever it comes around. With that being said though, I'm going to call it there for the video. I'll be sure to see you guys next time whenever that is. So, until that happens, keep on brawling.